Yeah, I'm 35 and I'm fitter than any 21-year-old. Because I'm as fit as a fiddle and I'm in the greatest shape of my life and I take my nutrition and my conditioning seriously.
British light welterweight champion. Yeah, so it's a privilege to working with him, and today we're gonna do a few techniques which are important at the moment. First of all, we're gonna work on his myofascial release.
Stop, right hand.
In his back, so we're gonna release it first, then we're gonna activate a few muscles which been sleeping recently. Now we're gonna work on some legs power and strength.
See, I got money on my mind, but they don't want to leave me alone. So I'm riding every day with every pistol.
The amount of the training of the professional boxer is around 20 to 25 hours a week of training. So it means sometimes they train 4 hours a day, which can lead to overtraining certain muscles. So what I'm doing, I'm kind of releasing tight areas, which kind of at the moment hold him back, so he can't train 100%. It's all about, you know, trying to perfect balance between training, recovery, you know. I'm using this myofascial release technique. I was just releasing fascia with my tool, and now trying to release one of the tight muscles around the scapula. When I first met Darren, obviously he was already a British champion, but I saw the potential in him, and I knew there's so much work he can do to improve his performance. So he was kind of like black canvas for me, you know. I saw I can, you know, tune in and I can make a big difference if I work on certain areas he didn't actually notice he need to work on. So one of them was his ankle mobility, his flexibility around the hips. And since we've been working on it, his balance, his strength, you know, increased very, very much. And I just think the main reason is because we work on that mobility on that ankle, and his performance is still improved.
Plus, you ask a boxer what's the game plan to go boxing, and look him up. Geronimo is a strategic way of how to beat every person is different. You know, you've got that Spencer Fury, he's the person who's doing all that. I've got the greatest boxing coach, yeah, trainer, Harry Meehan, fundamentals of boxing, yeah. They're calling me the fittest man in boxing. I'm about 35, I'm the fittest man in boxing. What's my fight? I throw more punches in the 12th round than in the first round. Why? Because I train harder than everyone else. When you come to the gym and watch me train at one TK regime, you'll see everyone how they train on the back. Yeah? The back work. That's just indicates every fight how they work. When I'm on the back, I'm fighting the back like the back dummy.
The technique is not 100% by compared to where he was before. It's a massive improvement. It used to be an issue, depth of the squat and the hips flexibility. So he's doing it, it's a big increase on his power when he's punching, and the general benefits are amazing.
Darren Hamilton. Just chilling in the gym, just done a quick session with his personal trainer. So what age were you like inspired by boxing, Darren?
What age? I think I was inspired by boxing. I think I was about 10 years. And I watched my first Rocky film.
Rocky inspired everyone, didn't it?
Rocky inspired everyone.
What would you say was the opponent you most thought about before the actual showdown, before the actual fight, if there was any?
To be honest, I think we fight equally.
Okay.
That whole process of thinking of what I'm going to do, mm-hmm. I think I have the equal amount of nerves as well. So fights where I probably fought more. I can't really think of one.
Darren Hamilton, the key is fitness.
Double the air attack! Come on, easy man!
Fitness is the key.
Double the air attack!
Thank you.
That's how we're going to distract this old idiot, man. With his big rotted teeth. Focus.
Bear Productions. TRU Camp. We does this. And we does that.
That's the one. Don't let him come over that top.
What he's doing is, when he's just touching you with the jab, what he's doing is, he's doing it to set something else up. Usually when you touch someone to the stomach, it opens up opportunities over the top. Yeah? Okay? You should have let me hit the air, because I was trying to show. Don't make me look bad. You should throw a jab to someone. It gives you respect, yeah? If someone's chasing you, and I run out of breath, and I want my breathing, he's running around the ring, I want a bit of breathing time, he needs to respect me. So there's no point in me going, Can you stop chasing me? He's not going to respect me, yeah? So you need to throw a decent jab. You throw the jab using your hips. Yeah? Okay? Right? So we're going to show how to activate your hips with the jab. So the jab, I'm touching. I want to respect the jab. That's the jab that I'm throwing. Leave me alone. Stay where you are. That's the power jab.
The first two rounds, I visualized fighting myself.
Okay, nice one.
Just
killed that last session. Killed the last, strong winning second part of the fight.
Yeah, that's good.
The way you do it, what you do is the way you fucking do it. Roman, trainer, Harry, and Spencer Fearon, who's my manager, and my melanin man, my motivation man, my Bandini Brown, is the greatest team on the planet. February the 22nd, let's do this thing, yeah. And anyone who's next in line, people, if your name ain't been top 20, if your name up in top 20, you can't really talk on it.
You're working around the other person methodically, like they're your opponent, yeah? All right, guys, we've got a couple of seconds left. Can you start the round? 5 seconds, get ready, guys. I want to see you outwork the person in front of you. No break, no break, no break. Lovely, lovely, yeah. Come on, Rossi.
Wander around until it found me, you know, like gossip found me.
No role model, but these models wanna roll. No role model, but these models wanna roll. No role model, but these models wanna roll. If it ain't about that money, I don't wanna know. No role model, but these models wanna roll. No role model, but these models wanna roll.
Big up ammo, yeah.
No role model, but these models wanna roll. If it ain't about that money, I don't wanna know.